myself, Deshmukh S C, working as assistant professor in civil engineering department of Walchand of technology. Today we are going to learn about rapidly varied flow. After completion of this topic, you are able to understand what is the concept of rapidly varied flow. You can derive the equation for conjugate depths, or we can say sequent depths, and also you can solve the problems on conjugate or sequent depths. First of all, we'll just see what is a rapidly varied flow. Last time we have seen the gradually varied flow, where the parameters are changing very gradually. Now here it is changing abruptly, or you can say rapidly. The rapidly varied flow phenomenon is a very unstable, and it has an inherent tendency to change itself to the stable tranquil flow, resulting in the abrupt rise in the elevation of liquid surface. The local phenomenon where the elevation of water surface is suddenly rises is called as a hydraulic jump or a standing flume. Let us see this figure. The flow is coming like this. Here it is a barrier, and it is coming abruptly down, and it flashes again coming up. See here, this is the water surface which is coming down. This is a collision, and it rises up. The rapidly varied flow we can observe over here. The rapidly varied flow we are observing over here. Here gradually it is changing very slowly, very slowly, very slowly. Here we can say it is a uniform flow, and this is a non-uniform flow up to where it is going to become a stable one. Now, as the example is hydraulic jump of the rapidly varied flow, we'll see what is a hydraulic jump. When a supercritical flow where the Froude's number is greater than 1 changes suddenly to the subcritical flow where the Froude's number is less than a hydraulic jump, less than 1 in the hydraulic jump. Why Froude's number we are taking? Because Froude's number is the ratio of inertia force to the gravity force. Due to the formation of hydraulic jump, large scale eddies are formed and the turbulence occurs, resulting in appreciable loss of kinetic energy takes place. Bidon, it is the name of the scientist, a French engineer, was the first to investigate the phenomenon of hydraulic jump experimentally in the year 1818. This is the same figure where you can observe the sudden rise over here. Okay, sudden rise you can observe here in the section 1 and section 2, and particularly here we are going to adopt, instead of energy equation, we are taking a momentum equation. Keep in your mind. Now define a hydraulic jump. The answer is, when a supercritical flow changes to subcritical flow, a considerable amount of energy loss takes place. With this phenomenon is termed as a hydraulic jump. Now, as appreciable loss of energy changes occurs in a very short length, this is a bit of the channel, it is advisable to apply a momentum equation instead of energy equation along the continuity equation for the analysis of hydraulic jump. As per Newton's second law of motion, algebraic sum of all the external forces in any direction is equal to change in momentum flux in the same direction. Therefore, applying the equation in the direction of flow to the control volume, this section between 1 and 2 is called as a control volume, you will get summation of fx, that is summation of all the forces, is equal to mass of the flow into change in the velocity. So it is rho, mass density, into discharge into velocity, that is final minus initial velocity. From figure, rho, q, v1, v2 are the density, discharge and initial velocity and final velocity respectively. Now the summation of fx is f1 minus f2 plus w sin theta minus f4 minus f5. See here, f1, it is in the direction of flow, F2 opposition, F4 and F5. This is a bottom resistance, this is the air resistance, and W sin theta is with respect to this flow. Where F1 and F2 are the pressure forces at section 1 and 2, that is from the figure. W sin theta is a component of the body force in the direction of the motion, and F4 and F5 are the channel bottom resistance and air resistance. Generally, F4 and F5 are very small, we are neglected, and the channel bottom being practically horizontal, the term W sin theta is also neglected. So solving these, we will get F1 minus F2 is equal to rho Q2 V2 minus rho Q1 V1. If we can solve it step by step, you will get F1 plus M1 is equal to F2 plus M2, where M1, that is a mass at section 1, that is rho Q1 V1, M2 is rho Q2 V2. Dividing the equation throughout by gamma, that is, or we can say, in many of the cases we are taking as W, or you can say gamma, that is specific weight. If you can divide this, you will get, again, simplify it slowly, dividing, you will get this equation, F1 plus M1 by gamma 1 is equal to F1 plus M2 upon gamma. That is, specific force before hydraulic jump is equal to specific force after the hydraulic jump is known as momentum equation for an open channel flow. This particular equation is very basic equation or important equation to derive the equation for the hydraulic jump. Fs, that is a specific force, depends on the depth of the flow, cross section of the channel and discharge passing through the channel. The above equation can also be written as A1 Y1 bar, that is Y1 bar plus Q square upon GA1 is equal to A2 Y2 bar plus Q square upon GA2. This is a very important equation. This equation is called as a momentum equation for an open channel flow. Now we'll see what is a hydraulic jump in a rectangular channel. What is the equation for this? For a frictionless rectangular horizontal channel, the momentum equation is the same. A1 Y1 bar plus Q square upon GA1 is equal to A2 Y2 bar plus Q square upon GA2. This we can write as B is the width and Y is the depth. Simplify it, B into Y1, that is the area of 1, and remaining as it is, A2 is B into Y2. Put these values over here. Wherever area is there, you can go for width into depth. Where Y1 and Y2 are the depths of the flow at section 1-1 and section 2-2 respectively. That is before and after the hydraulic jump. And B is the width, which I said to you. Therefore, dividing the whole equation by B, you will get this equation. Also, we know Q by B is a small q, that is discharge per meter width. Putting these values, Q square for Q by B, that is capital Q by B square in the above equation, put these values and solve this quadratic equation. Solve this quadratic equation once in Y1 and once in Y2. You will get Y1 square Y2 plus Y1 Y2 square minus 2 Q square upon G is equal to 0, or Y1 Y2 square plus Y1 square Y2 minus 2 Q square upon G is equal to 0, which is in Y2. Again, simplify it for Y1. You will get the equation Y1 upon Y2 is equal to 1 half into bracket minus 1 plus under root 8 FR2 square. Similarly, the following equation we can write as with respect to the Froude's number, where Y1 and Y2 are known as the conjugate depths or the sequent depths, known as the ratio of these two. This is also a relation between the pre-jump and the post-jump. Here, the important thing, that is Q square upon G Y2 cube, that we have to insert with respect to the derivation. While deriving this, we should we should also focus on this, what the quadratic equation, and find out the ratio of these conjugate depths y1 upon y2. This is most important, and this equation is also known as the equation for the hydraulic jump, that is y2 and y1. Okay, for this, these are the reference books.